Hello guys, my name is Bharat Nagnath and today we are going to learn how to install VirtualBox and also install Ubuntu into it. So VirtualBox is a virtual machine developed by Oracle, and basically in this you can run any operating system other than the already installed Windows. Like you can run Ubuntu, like I'm running right now in the small window. And you can actually use this as your operating system. Like if you want to use Ubuntu while keeping your Windows as it is, then you can go with this method rather than the traditional method. So let's get started. Alright, there are two main requirements for this installation process, and those are given in the links below in the description. Please check out. And the first link would be the Ubuntu disk image that we will be downloading from the Ubuntu official website. After you open the link, just click on the download button and it will download it for you. I have already downloaded it, and as you can see, it's 1.81 GB. So you have to download this and keep. And also the second link is of the VirtualBox. And it shows the latest version that has been released. And if you have if you're using Windows, then click on this Windows host. And also this would start the download for the VirtualBox. Once you have both the requirements, the VirtualBox setup and the Ubuntu disk image, you're good to go and install the VirtualBox setup. So just click on it and just hit next and next and next and hit yes and install. It will ask for the administrator control. Just provide it and it will start installing. All right, so VirtualBox has been installed into my system. Now there has been a okay, it just opened by itself. All right, so just tap on new and just give it the name Linux and choose Ubuntu from the drop down menu in the version section. Ubuntu 64-bit. Next, and this is where you allocate the memory for your the secondary operating system for your Ubuntu. So as you can see, my RAM is of 8 GB. That's why it's showing 8192 MB. So out of that, how much of the memory space I'm allocating for my secondary operating system, that is for Ubuntu. So the more you give, faster your Ubuntu will work. So I'm right now giving it as 2 GB of RAM space for it to work. You can also give 1.5 GB, like 1500 MB. So let's tap on next. And just select create a virtual hard disk now. Create. And just tap next. Next. All right, so we are allocating the hard disk space for your secondary operating system, where all the important files and where the OS will be installed. So we are naming it as Linux disk, and just and it has been taken up 10 GB for that. So I think it's enough for just showing you guys. So you will see this. But when you open this, it would show that there's nothing to boot from. So go just right click on it and go to settings. And in that, in storage, click on this control ID and then you'll see something like empty, no disk image file selected. So click on this icon and choose virtual optical disk file. So this is where you will provide the disk image file of the Ubuntu that you downloaded, 1.8 GB file, the .iso file, this one, which we downloaded some minutes ago. Just select this and here you can see the changes. It's showing Ubuntu 18.04.1. So just press OK and now select this and hit start. So this is our secondary operating system. So basically this is like installing Windows. It will take about 15 minutes to install. You will see the installation page and all the requirements, and it will ask for all the settings that you want to do for installation of the new OS. Alright, so this is the Ubuntu installation setup. So this, select your language. I prefer English, so I'll select English and I'll hit install Ubuntu. And the keyboard layout is US, so continue. And now it depends on you. You can either check this mark, or if you don't want, don't do it. So just press continue. So yeah, the first option is okay, because however using a virtual disk, that means nothing from your C drive that is belonging to Windows will be erased. So it's safe to choose that option and press install now. Press continue and this is your time zone, and Kolkata is a time zone for India. So I'll let it be and continue. Alright, so you're giving a name to your operating system, your account. So I'll just give my name, Bharat, and password. I'll give something. Okay. Then continue. Alright, so it will take about 15 minutes to install this, all the files. All right, so it has been around 5 minutes, maybe, but it might take around up to 15 minutes. So it says installation complete. So I'll press restart now. Now it says remove the installation media and then press enter. But for you don't need to do anything. Just press enter in your keyboard on your keyboard. It will reboot itself. All right, so it is showing my account here. Just click on it and give the password which you gave, or if you didn't give, then just click on your account name and it will open automatically. So this is the first time we are opening Ubuntu, so it will take a little delay to open for the first time, but when you open for the next all the few times, then it will be opening very fast. So yeah, here it is. We can see our main home page where Ubuntu is installed, and it is showing some internal setups. This next, next, and done, and basically you can see now you can use applications on Ubuntu as well, and also you can use your applications from the Windows as well while using in Ubuntu. Like you can open terminal here. And maybe you can browse in Google Chrome from your Windows. So there is a lot of flexibility for what you want to do when you install VirtualBox. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Please, if you like this video and if it helped you, then please press the subscribe button below. And also hit the thumbs up button. Thank you.